Yamada is capable of upsets. We've seen it from Yamada in the past, but this is Sangmanee in Bangkok. This is the generational athlete, the 22-year-old million-dollar baby, the pinafore, the heartthrob of Thailand's Muay Thai scene. Sangmanee's southpaw starts. Pilot round house kick from here. Yamada looks to throw the hand towards the heavy artillery. Inside leg kick from Yamada. Sangmanee runs up high. Covers a left roundhouse kick. Goes downstairs as Yamada trying to tenderize that lead inside five. This crowd ooing and ahhing every time Sangmanee lands. And he ducks it into the body. He comes in for the elbow. There's the elbow off the left. Sangmanee puts on a show early and cracks away to the upper right ribcage. What a start here for the million-dollar baby.
Yeah, Michael, we're seeing a very aggressive start coming from Sangmanee. But Kenta Yamada is right there, standing in the pocket, trying to let go of that big overhand right. Sangmanee's got to keep tenderizing that right side of the body of Kenta Yamada, getting to drop that leg and wrap that shin around the head.
Sangmanee probing with the right jack. There's the left roundhouse kick from the top. Left hand falls short, Yamada with a short left hook. Dances out of the way of trouble. Four rounds guard against the round kick, but he took the full brunt of it and it hurt him. You saw a little grimace there from Yamada. Sangmanee turns it around and dumps him in the corner like yesterday's garbage. Beautiful work here from Sangmanee. Cracking round kick again. He's found the spot under that right arm of Yamada. It's the target for Sangmanee. He's going after it now. Trying to break down the body. Crossing elbow there from Yamada. Sangmanee resets himself, works that back leg again. More kick for the chorus line for Sangmanee sucking Muay Thai in the opening round. But Yamada's game, full of guts and intestinal fortitude, the Japanese. Front kick there from Sangmanee. Yamada counters, nice elbow.
A lot of body kicks coming from Sangmanee, but Yamada's taking him. He's not really letting him affect him too much because he's taking a lot of him on the arm, but that arm's going to start to drop the more it gets tenderized because those left kicks are not going to stop coming.
Look how Yamada grimaces in pain when those left round kicks hit the humerus. There's nothing funny about it. He looks on the quick, tries to throw the knee, but Sangmanee folds him in half with that knee in the midsection. Another tracking round kick and another the forearm of Yamada. How many more can he take?
Sangmanee is letting these body kicks go. Here's a beautiful example of that. Look at that, just beautifully timed, waiting for the arms to move.
Sangmanee sucking in Muay Thai, goes back to that fabled left leg and hit. Cracking away the forearm of Yamada. Yamada looks for an elbow, tries to lift the ear. Hawking knee, another elbow there from Yamada. Good work on the inside. Sangmanee the jab. Yamada throws heavy. Good overhand right there from Yamada. Just didn't have the staff behind it. That right hand between the eyes did. Yamada's got to get inside the phone booth and land that right hand. Can't stay in kicking range. This crowd screaming. Oohs and ahs and gnashing of teeth every time Sangmanee lands. Yamada tries to duke his way in there. Double forearm guard. Goes down low. Sangmanee the check. Circles off counterclockwise. Sangmanee looks on the money tonight. He looks better than he did last time. That left leg has been an absolute trick.
Yamada's trying to close that distance, utilize those elbows. Be as good when he's inside boxing range. But you can see Sangmanee's got very good boxing defense. He's able to deflect a lot of these punches that Yamada's throwing at him.
Downward elbow, hoping for the collarbone there, and from Sangmanee. Downward elbow again from Sangmanee. Fakes the back kick. Cuts off the movement. Nice work from Sangmanee. Oh, big ground kick. That shook the entire body of Yamada. Yamada's cut.
Injury time.
Yamada's cut. And referee calls time to take a look because it is over the eye, over the left eye of Yamada. Sangmanee, a house on fire tonight, Dragon. It is superb to watch.
Yeah, he's definitely over those one championship jitters. He said he wanted to put on a performance, and that's exactly what he's doing. He's doing a beautiful job of finding a rhythm with that left kick. And then as soon as he sees Yamada start to retaliate, he slides in with that elbow. And that's what cut up the eyelid of Yamada, was just those beautifully timed elbows. He's got pinpoint accuracy when he comes diving in like a hot knife through butter, just slicing the guard of Yamada up. Beautifully done. I like to see him just keep hammering away, but Yamada's got to change this. He can't. He's got to step in. When Sangmanee starts to throw that left kick, Yamada's got to step straight in and throw one right down the middle.
Yamada's okay to go on here. And it's been all one-way traffic as Sangmanee set him the attack. With the left kick, here goes again to the right. Yamada leans back like Petro, so too does Sangmanee. Left kick again from Sangmanee. Yamada almost folding in half from that one. Another one backs him up a couple of paces. The power in that rear leg of Sangmanee and the precision. He swings away like Manus Lovershane, swinging the bat from the cricket crease this summer. Big elbow there from Sangmanee. Big red hook kick again on the inside now. Yamada wants the right elbow. Sangmanee though swings off the left. Spinning back elbow. And a red kick. Up again elbow from Yamada. The Japanese veteran, the war horse. He backs off and resets. And Sangmanee is not going to show him in the match. Continues to punish Yamada. 25 seconds remaining, second round of three. Sangmanee, the left leg has been an absolute battering ram. But here comes Yamada, digging down deep into the well of guts and intentional fortitude. He's not going to go quietly into the night.
That's what Yamada needs to do. He needs to go forward, stay away from that left kick, and start letting those hands go. Because if you can watch, you can start to see Yamada's right hand starting to drop down. You can change the course of your fate ultra fast. Look at that. Beautifully, that was it. Yep, he stepped right in, caught him on the elbow. He looks like he was going to throw the body kick.
And touch clock. Sangmanee, the southpaw, dominant with his left roundhouse kick to the body and to the right forearm. It's been prime weapon, and here it is again. Yamada goes to the inside leg. Sangmanee, left round kick, left elbow. That's a little jerk and hook there from the top, and then goes upstairs. Reverberating around this massive arena. And again, the shin just thudding into the carcass of Yamada. So the forearms go up, those arms are starting to fall apart.
Yamada is getting so sore tomorrow morning when he gets up. He's probably incredibly sore right now. These shots, you can hear the thud of these kicks against the body of Yamada.
Yamada will not be able to stretch his back tonight. And another punishing kick. And more into the body, into the arms of Yamada. He's got no answers. It's all Sangmanee. Dominance, control. You can sign the pink slips. You can sign the ownership papers. The kicks off the left leg of Sangmanee. He is putting on a show. He is putting on a display of the power, the ferocity of the Muay Thai roundhouse kick. Million Dollar Baby has thrown about a million kicks tonight. If kicks were people, Sangmanee would be China. Beautiful short right hand there from Sangmanee. And Yamada's gonna find something, 110 remaining, but what's he got? It may be just about protection now for Yamada. It may be just about survival. Sangmanee setting the left hand, the left kick again. There it goes into the body. It's a kaleidoscope of color now. Reds and purples and pinks. Like it's been sunburned. The right side of the body of Yamada. And again, Sangmanee for kicks. They are not with the foot. They are not with the ankle or the instep. They are with the shin. Yamada tries to pin him against the ropes. Sangmanee turns and gets out of top. Half a minute remaining. Spinning back fist from Yamada. Sangmanee goes the round kick again. It hurts me just looking at it.
Yamada's not letting that Bushido spirit die. He is standing in the pocket, just playing with the sharp side of the blade that is coming from Sangmanee.
It's that unwavering Bushido spirit that all of our Japanese warriors have. The never say die attitude, the no split trick, no surrender. Yamada still juking it out for the final bout.
Just over and over, he goes to the body, changes things up. As Yamada starts to drop the hand, the foot goes to the face, but just smashing into the body of Yamada repeatedly. Just a beautiful performance from the Million Dollar Baby.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Sangmanee Satyen Muay Thai.
In Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam, we're here for the first time ever. It's an all-one Super Series strike and show. Exploding with a combination off the ropes. Oh, and held by 5 feet. Siri with the jab. Nice two-punch combination from the Italian. Stick through knee, outside thigh kick from one Colpin. Body punch. Oh, and Siri returns the favor. Now takes the Italian's feet.
Nice push kick there thrown by Lassiri off his rear leg. Uncle Pet is just throwing some serious heat with each one of his shots. He's trying to touch up that leg too, Lassiri.
Charge of the elbows here on the inside for Lassiri. Muay Thai rules for this one. 4 ounce gloves in employment. Crossing elbow from Uncle Pet. Front kick from Lassiri, trying to maintain some distance. Uncle Pet just trying to kick through his mouth. Outside leg kick from Uncle Pet. Good outside knee kick from Monkolpet and the right hand. As Mitch said, the power salvos early here for Monkolpet. There's a glancing right from Lassiri, throws the knees. Lassiri wants to slice and dice with some elbows. Brave game to play, getting on the inside with Monkolpet. Monkolpet ties him up, Lassiri throws knee to the waist. Monkolpet crossing elbow, looking for the hairline. Elbow coming from Monkolpet, moment. Lassiri just gets out of danger. Nice jack. Big kick. Getting that common peroneal nerve is Monkolpet. Two punch combination from the tie. Three punch combination from the tie. Lassiri comes forward. Monkolpet's got the power, but I do like the tempo from Yosef Lassiri so far, Mitch.
His tempo is just constant. He keeps that pace on his opponents. There's no backwards motion whatsoever from Lassiri. He only moves forward. But he's also having a difficult time with the range. You can see that every time he tries to get too close, that's when Monkolpet kind of clinches up or he's pushing him away with his push kicks. That's the range that he needs to be in, but Monkolpet gets that clinch.
This version of Yosef Lassiri is completely different to the one that made his one Super Series debut against the great Samai Gangadao. Different monster now, Yosef Lassiri. Confidence after that first win back in Tokyo. Uppercut from Lassiri.
That elbow though, Monkolpet. Slightly, everything is so accurate from Monkolpet.
Nice elbow from Lassiri, crossing elbow to the jaw of Monkolpet. A duck there from Lassiri. Well, that sends a message to Monkolpet, no doubt about it. That took from Monkolpet, doubles up on it. That's that crunchy armbar ending.
You can see in these first couple of exchanges, just the power that was coming out of Monkolpet. Here he goes, going right up top. Beautiful push kick to the face off the rear leg.
Both men traded some very good front kicks in the opening round to each other's mouths. Good right hand there from Lassiri. High check from Lassiri. Monkolpet ties him up. Knee from Lassiri scores for him and evades the two-punch combination.
Lassiri's got to check those leg kicks because that's what's happening. You just see how he digs that shin into the thigh of Lassiri. Nice nice elbow there landed by Lassiri. He's doing better inside that range, inside that close clinch range. If you're close enough to touch, you can hit him.
Talk about the shins of Mongkol Tempi. Muay Thai practitioners' shin, particularly those from Thailand, are harder than the shins of normal people. Kicking the heavy bags and years of kicking hard objects causes microfractures on the shins. A process called cortical remodeling. Fractures heal up, they form a harder bone on the surface. The nerves deaden, the shin bones turn into bludgeons.
Interesting clinch there from Mongkol Pet. I was controlling the elbow of Lassiri.
Took again from Mongkol Pet, one of the best punches for Mongkol Pet tonight. Lassiri tries to thread an uppercut. Knee there from Lassiri. The goal, he dumps him again! How do you do? Twice, Josef Lassiri has dumped Mongkol Pet. Mitch in Thailand, that would be almost unheard of.
In one Super Series, it's almost unheard of to have Lassiri be doing this to Mongkol Pet. He's doing a good job inside that clinch.
Close score for Josef Lassiri. And they mean that psychologically, each time Lassiri dumps him, Mongkol Pet has to pick himself up off the canvas. Lassiri gaining in confidence, tries for a downward elbow. Mongkol Pet will go back to that left hook that's been effective for him. It's a round kick off the lead leg, no switch up on it. Right hand from Lassiri, backs up Mongkol Pet, tags him with a left. Mongkol Pet ties him up with Lassiri trying to dump him. Elbow from Mongkol Pet. Lassiri tries to line up the right hand. Mongkol Pet's chin a little far forward, doesn't matter, throws the right, catches him on the jaw. Lassiri does a quick count of his teeth, and referee Olivia Cost breaks them.
You can see Lassiri keeps his guard nice and tight, nice and close to his body. You can see how close his elbows are, so he's minimizing a lot of the damage. Nice little catch there, spun it around, threw a kick. Good job from Josef Lassiri. See how he keeps that on the arm? Very tight guard, so he's minimizing any body shots thrown by Mongkol Pet.
I'm just amazed how good Lassiri is looking tonight. He continues to improve out of sight with every contest. Twice he has dumped Mongkol Pet. Found his fair share of hands and some legs as well in the Thai legend. Roundhouse kick from Mongkol Pet. We're going into the third. Mongkol Pet certainly, no doubt about it, has the hardest elbows. But again there, you see clean blows landed for Josef Lassiri. Volume over the power of Mongkol Pet. Mongkol Pet with the knee, Lassiri returns it.
So Lassiri
from Mongkol Pet, one more from Lassiri.
He wanted to avoid the clinch, but he's doing really good work inside the clinch. He's able to find that this range right here when he steps in. He's able to land some good hand combinations. I like the push kick fakes that he's throwing out there as he tries to go airborne there.
And let me tell you, folks, if Lassiri does get the nod in this one, as Mongkol Pet dumps in, if Lassiri does get the nod, it would be considered a major upset.
Josef Lassiri just pushed Olivia Cost out of the way because he wanted to march forward and grab a hold of Mongkol Pet. I love it.
Lassiri continually on the front foot. Again, he comes forward with left foot from the Italian, goes down to the bread basket. Italy, they call it the bread basket. Olivia Cost breaks them. Forward coming again, Lassiri. Looking to back up Mongkol Pet. Left roundhouse kick from the Italian. Nice defense. Then goes the liver. There's an elbow. It's all scoring stuff again from Josef Lassiri.
Stop. Break. Talk.
Mongkol Pet on the ropes. Lassiri went back to the liver once more. Chance for the elbows here. Can he get the arm free? He does. There's two elbows off the right from Lassiri. Left hook from Lassiri. Nicely done. Comes forward again, the Italian.
He's doing a great job of minimizing the damage that he's taking from Mongkol Pet, especially when Mongkol Pet is at kicking range. Lassiri just keeps coming forward, finding that distance and throwing.
Mitch, Mongkol Pet starting to look fatigued here in Ho Chi Minh City. He's blowing up a storm. There's another elbow from Josef Lassiri. Mongkol Pet, roundhouse kicks off the left leg. Lassiri backs him up once more. Confidence oozing on the Italian. Elbow uppercut. Left hook from Lassiri. Combination work from Josef Lassiri. And another left hook from Lassiri. He's backing up Mongkol Pet once more.
Hurricane just keeps coming forward. Just break to Mongkol Pet. He's consistently working. Look at this. He's constant. Just barrage of shots just keeps coming from Lassiri.
Josef Lassiri, I believe this is a career high performance from the Italian. He's performing better than he did in Tokyo. In the anything he did against Hiroki Akimoto back in March. Jack Tumasiri still trying to walk Moncalpec down. Moncalpec continually on the back foot. Lasirith and elbow stings him. Lasirith, the elbows in the corner, toe to toe in a phone booth.
Moncalpec did land a nice right hand there, though, right before he started to clinch up.
Only a few seconds remaining. This is a stellar performer from Josip Lasiri. Double forearms guard. Gets on the inside again. They clinch up. Is there a final dump here? A magnificent maestro performance from Josip Lasiri, who pumps his fist in the air and has a smile from ear to ear.
That was a close one too. Man, I would so difficult to be a judge. Look at this. Lasiri comes in. He eats a kick there, but then he marches forward, consistently pushing forward, landing big shots. There's a nice straight right hand there as Moncalpec, being the veteran that he is, clinches up to minimize damage.
By majority decision from the red corner, Moncalpec,
on both these men. Jab from Saka. Inside leg kick from Bobo Saka. Nice jab from Saka. Checks the low kick. Good long reach here from Bobo Saka. Outside leg kick from Philip Dunn. Built like an absolute powerhouse is Philip Dunn. Kicks the lead leg. Arm of thigh. And again, choosing one spot. He's going to try and deaden that leg. Kicks the leg once more. Flurry on the inside there from Philip Dahm. Saka, long-reaching jab. Philip Dahm continues to hit the leg. One way to slow down the punches of your opponent is to take out his legs.
You can see the way Bobo Saka is kind of overextending on his punches because he's having to punch down to Philip Dahm. And Philip Dahm loves to time that overhand left. It'll be interesting to watch how this match progresses with that left hand of Philip Dahm.
You can't move your feet, you cannot box properly. Both men wearing the Project armbands around their biceps. Nice two-punch combination from Philip Dahm. Big outside leg kick from the tie. Short right hand there from Sacco.
The job of Sacco starting to land.
Lightning really has kick. You want to connect though with the front of the shin rather than the slap of the instep. Jab two from Sacco. Outside leg kick from Philip Dahm. Off the ropes now. Sacco, nice leg kick that time. Turned it around for the sciatic nerve. Philip Dahm comes in with such a big reputation. Seven knockouts in a row at Channel 7 Stadium in Thailand. Almost unheard of. Nice turning right hand there from Philip Dahm. Snappy jab from Saka.
Is starting to step out. He has these little steps that he does. He's trying to cut the corner when he turns out to the right. But Philip Dahm is timing it. He's connecting with his leg kicks and overhand lefts.
That's why they call him the left meteorite. And the meteorite crashed on the face of Bobo Saka. Saka ties him up. Philip Dahm drops his back.
Sacco's got to slow this down. We're going to get a minute break here in a minute.
High kick from Bobo.
Watch this. Look at that. Just right on the top of the head. Landed beautifully there by Philip Dahm. And that wobble, that was a delayed reaction. It slowly sunk in. And then the leg started to give way. And then he caught him again.
Philip Dahm, full of confidence, Mitch.
He's got to be careful stepping off to that right. He does that a lot. I've seen it from a lot of his past fights. He likes to throw, step off to the right. Philip Dahm timed it. again with that left hand.
Pull him down, Bogey. And Bogey Saka, look at him saying, come on, what have you got? Let's bring it. Torching, baiting, Bogey Saka. Getting inside the Frenchman's head. Playing physical and psychological games. Nice knee there from Bogey Saka. Pull up down. A young man of such massive power and technique.
The adjustments on the footwork from Sacco. He's not stepping off like that. He's also utilizing that jab.
Ooh, that left hook. Just wrapping towards the drill of Bobo Sacco. Sacco at the point of time. Try to pull the head down for the main two break.
Smiles at him. There's that left hand again. It's like he's swinging a sock full of rocks at the face of Bobo Sacco.
Sacco should try and launch that knee again. The way of the leverage, he does just that. Pulling the opponent down while driving the knee up to deliver up to 2.5 tons of force. Enough to lift a car. Incredible if he can latch on and pull the head down.
Stop! It's all right. Hey, be careful, yeah? Careful what you need.
Hearing strike.
Box!
Bobo Sacco needs to get up first here. Outside leg kick from the Frenchman. Tries to double up on it. Ooh, there's the clinch from Bobo.
Let's
see how he's changed the game plan now. It's not about distance. It's about getting on the inside and clinching up with Kulabdar. Maybe his corner believes they now have the upper hand in the clinch with the elbows and the knees.
Good up and up the straight left hand combination landed by Sacco.
Sacco, left hook. Referee Deluxe just breaks them. 20 second round, second round victory. No round this from Kulabdan. After the explosiveness of the first stanza. Comes forward now the top. You see the Muay Thai stance, the elbows flared out. Arms turned out to catch the kicks on the forearms, catch the elbows. Hurry away the jabs.
Stop!
Eventually the rhythm's going to get you, and it's getting pulled down so far here in the third. Bobo Sacco teeing off on him. Nice jab from the Frenchman. Will he let him off the ropes? Keeps him there. Low kick, uppercut. Well threaded from Sacco. Sacco's corner are going off their rockets. Barking instructions at Amir. Double forearms guard from Kulabdan. Sacco powers through the lockdown. Nicely done from Bobo Sacco. It's been all one-way traffic. It's been all the Frenchman here in the third round.
Yeah, he's had a much better round here in the third. He's really starting to turn it on. Kulabdan has slowed, and Bobo Sacco has turned it on.
Listen.
1:05 remaining. Sacco on the front foot. Kulabdan showing no idea the power. The second.
He landed with that left hand though.
Sacco ties him up, throws the knees. Knee guard put on by Kulabdan. Definitely second round so far. Don't know too much French, but know that Ale means go. I want Seko to go. I want to go get some cool up down for the final 30 seconds. And I'm going to go for the time.
Down two rounds, so he's got to end it in this one, Michael.
Two world champions in the ring. Seko to front kick.
Nice push kick by Cool Up Dom.
Step right.
Come on. Referee collapses, just breaks him.
Seko waits forward. Has he got one big salvo remaining? Oh, beautifully cutting kick to the midsection there from Cool Up Dom. Five, the left meteorite. And that is the end of the round. We are going down to the judges' stand in the field.
He was able to do so much good work, especially when he got Cool Up Dom against the ropes here. Look at him, boom, two punches land, three, four, five, all connected.
By unanimous decision from the red corner.
Aggressive with the right kicks.
Three kicks in all. Good start from him. There's the fourth, going upstairs with it. Nothing coming from Wiratchai so far. It's all Amir Khan. Spurred on by his home crowd here. Really absolutely packed house here. Great atmosphere in Singapore. Perhaps the best atmosphere we've had in this stadium where it all began.
Shannon's getting a little bit flat-footed, not really moving around. Amir Khan is just picking his shots with that right kick.
Well, Shannon tried to just hold that foot and tried to cuff him with the right hand. Didn't quite set it up perfectly, though. Right hand there from Amir.
He's rushing him. I like Amir's strategy here. Moving forward, using his dominant size. Shannon just kind of shaking it off. That usually means he got him a bit.
Ooh. Tremendous balance, isn't he, Amir?
A little bit low, a little bit low.
Time.
Shannon realizing a mistake, just kind of shaking it off. Amir definitely has a strategy going with that right kick to that left side. You can see when one fighter is right, one fighter is left, it opens up that side of the body. And Amir Khan has taken full advantage of it.
That was a real mixed martial arts combination from Wiratchai. Punch, punch, elbow, elbow.
Shannon's got to be a little bit more aggressive. He's just kind of waiting for Amir Khan to attack and then strike back. I'd like to see Shannon initiate some combinations here.
Yep, it's all Amir at the moment in terms of initiating attacks, isn't it? And he likes that kick. He's got great balance, especially when he brings that right leg up very high. His stability on that left leg of his is tremendously solid.
But I don't think Shannon can keep eating those right kicks from Amir.
I tell you what, though, Shannon is coming back with good left hands, and they're scoring, too. There's a good right from Amir.
Tried to catch an answer. Amir's got to be careful with that inside right kick he's throwing. Yup, he's trying to catch it. Ooh, he's catching him. Nice. Oh, here comes that clinch of Amir. Shannon's got the underhook there. Amir's got to try to spin away from the cage so he can get his hips into some of those knees.
Nice work, 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 work.
That's it. Shannon's so strong up against that cage.
What a nice little short left hand that is. Sort of hook, uppercut from Wiratchai with Amir pressed up against the cage. It's a good action-packed first 3 minutes that we've seen.
Shannon's dropping his hands a little bit. We got to keep those hands up, especially with a striker with the capability of Amir Khan.
How is Amir Khan on the floor, Mitch? Is it perhaps in his thoughts to get down onto the mat and take advantage?
I definitely think so, but Shannon has really good takedown defense. You know, he learned a lot from our first fight where I was controlling the ground position. So in the second fight, his ground defense was so much better. He's really evolved and he's added that element to his game. So Amir Khan might be trying to wear him down in the later rounds, take it to the ground.
These two are unleashing. It's a very intriguing an enthralling stand-up contest so far. Directly above us here at cage side, Wiratchai with his back against the cage.
See, now Khan has his hips. Now he can start using his hips to throw those knees and those elbows. That's where he likes. Oh, he turned with an elbow.
Ooh, it was the elbow that caught Wiratchai, and he's rocked a little bit, isn't he?
Yeah, I think Wiratchai is a little bit dazed. It's smart to go to the clinch. Amir should push away and start striking again.
Took a few steps back to just solidify his stance on the cage there, and then clinch, as you said, Mitch.
We're in that final minute of the first round here.
Be interested to get to Rich Franklin's view on who's got the better of this first 5 minutes, because it's all been in the stand-up, and they're both very talented in that area. The aggressor certainly is Amir Khan.
Yeah, he is moving forward. He's got a good strategy by attacking the open side of Wiratchai's body, and now he's just got him up against the cage. You know, Shannon's been focusing on the TV thing. I don't know if he's really put in the work that Amir has. Amir's been fighting regularly, trying to get as much work as he can before he goes to national service. I don't know if Shannon's gonna have the gas tank to keep up with Khan.
Well, good right hand.
I like
from
that
Shannon.
Hook of his. It is catching him too.
There it is, another left. Oh, and another one. Oh, that really did catch Amir Khan. 2 seconds before the bell rang, he got his own bell rung, didn't he, Amir Khan? Having probably had the better of that first 5 minutes, he just got a little waking up call in the final few moments. Is trying to arrange his national service such that he can continue to train and fight. And it'll be a pleasure to watch him do that.
I like how he keeps attacking that right lead leg of Wiratchai, trying to slow Wiratchai down. Take away some of that explosiveness, especially that right hook that Wiratchai does so well. See if Khan can put together some combinations. Wiratchai stalking forward. Yeah, Steve, you're right. The Singaporean MMA scene has just exploded. And it is very evident here tonight at this packed Singapore indoor stadium. This crowd is electrified right now by their hometown boy, Amir Khan.
We saw something like that in the first round. Amir getting his kick caught and then taking one on the chin. So watch out for that.
See, Shannon's being a little bit more aggressive in moving forward in this fight. So there's a little bit of blood there. It looks like it's coming from the left eye
of Amir Khan, just up there in the corner. Above the eye. I don't think the blood's going to run into the eye, which is the problem with cuts on and around the eyebrow. It looks as if it's going to run down the side of the face, so that's one advantage.
See, Shannon understands what Amir does well with the clinch. He's defending it very well, smiles at him.
Often when a fighter realizes he's cut, he steps up his game just a little bit, and I think we saw that from Amir. It's a little flurry, the intensity of which we haven't seen.
Yeah, there's always in the back of your mind that something like a cut can stop the fight, so you have to increase the intensity even more to make sure that the fight isn't stopped. And it's not affecting you. Nice right hand by Amir Khan.
And it was acknowledged by Shannon as well. It was right on the button, wasn't it? Pushed his head back, straight right hand.
Guys, action.
That guard of Shannon, not as high as his opponent's, and he's vulnerable to a quick, snappy right hand like that.
Yeah, Wiratchai does not come from the strict Muay Thai background that most of the Thai fighters do. He comes from a judo background. He likes the unorthodox striking style, but he does have power.
Loving these single punches from Amir. He took a great elbow from Shannon there. Hardly seemed to faze him.
That was beautifully executed. He ducked under the punch and threw that elbow. That is a very highly, highly skilled Muay Thai technique.
Incredible timing to do that.
As I just say, he's not a Muay Thai efficient. He throws one of the classic Muay Thai elbows. Shannon loves making me look bad.
I know, what are you getting a complex, Mitch?
Oh, man, I already have one. But I am enjoying this contest here tonight.
Well, Amir said part of his incentive to do well tonight.
Nice elbows by Wiratchai, landed in the clinch up against the cage.
Part of his incentive is to get revenge for you. But it's a struggle, isn't it? How exposed are you when you catch a kick just like that, Mitch? Because both of your hands are busy, aren't they? So you can't defend your face.
But he's actually catching with one hand, and so it's actually highly technical to, you know, deliver punches and strikes. It looks like Shannon's trying to catch the kick, throw the kick, and land a strike at the same time. But Amir is striking immediately after getting it caught.
Oh, this is a cracking fight. Both men giving and receiving punches. It's really a thrill for the fans here. They're on their feet and applauding. 1 minute left in the second round, and the entertainment value is high.
Oh,
there's a takedown.
Scores a nice takedown in the final minute of the second round.
How significant will that be when we reach the 10-minute mark with five to go?
We'll have to get Rich Franklin here to chime in on that to see how if that swayed.
Punches. Don't forget, Amir's got a cut above his left eye, so those punches won't do him any good, although they landed pretty much on the right-hand side of his head.
Those punches aren't going to do much damage, except that he has that cut, and that's the only difference maker. It's kind of annoying to be hit from that position. You can see him trying to stretch out the arm to hook it under his legs, but Shannon's defending really well.
Oh,
so he's finally
done it,
gets it.
Oh, and,
he rolls out.
He rolled around.
Very good ground game.
What a cracking contest. Final 10 seconds. Stick around, everyone. We got five more minutes of this.
Amir controlling Wiratchai up against the cage. And Shannon kind of saying he has nothing.
At the 10-minute mark, it is looking more and more like the judges will be called upon to give us their decision about who's won this fight. Let's go to a man.
That's the elbow.
That was the elbow, wasn't it?
That was beautiful.
What impact did that have on your scoring, Rich Franklin?
Wow, let me tell you, this fight, this could be anybody's fight right now. I have these guys dead even on damage inflicted. I have these guys dead even on striking superiority. Obviously, Amir, towards the end of the round there, was able to score the takedown. He was able to control Wiratchai there for about 60 seconds on the ground. So that's going to put him ahead on the scorecards as far as I'm concerned at this point in time.
Mitch, not easy to score properly when you're commentating. I appreciate that, but who would you have ahead of this stage?
I gotta give the slight edge to Amir Khan, the way that he finished, you know, that final 9 to 9 minute mark, how he got the takedown controlled from the ground. Wiratchai did pop up, but it's a very, very close fight, and this third round could be the decision maker.
Yeah, I think it could be. I think you're right. I also think that Amir is probably slightly ahead, but I think that Shannon is coming to the fore, and if I had to predict this final 5 minutes, it would probably go to Shannon. So let's see.
I questioned Shannon's gas tank in the beginning of this fight, but it doesn't look like that's a problem at all. Attempts the front kick.
He had a little grab at it again, didn't he, Shannon? He likes to hold that kick and see what he can achieve while his man's on one leg.
But Amir seems to be defending that very well, very comfortable. I like the high guard of Amir, keeping his face protected.
Yeah, he does a good job there, but he ate a cracking right hand to the jaw.
That was beautiful. He pawed the hand down and came, slipped right over with that right jab.
Took a nice left hand inside there as well, Amir.
I would like to see Amir use some wrestling right now and possibly take this fight to the ground. But Shannon spins him around. He used that underhook to get him around. Once you have that underhook, that arm under Amir's left arm, he has much better control of him. And he's trying to use the hand to control position.
Break.
Yeah, that was a stalemate. And Joey LePeyton did a very good job to bring him back to the center of the cage. Oh. Amir Khan going to work. Throws more punches.
Moving forward. Shannon's not backing down. He's coming forward, too.
Still the busier of the two. Shannon throws impressive one-punch shots. Eye-catching, certainly scoring with the judges, but Amir is busier, and that counts for an awful lot.
The crowd here is getting behind their Singaporean and trying to urge him on to victory to give him that little bit extra push.
Well, if we're all correct, and Amir Khan was ahead at the 10-minute mark, we're now at the 12-minute mark, and there are 3 minutes left for Shannon to make up that ground, if indeed He is in deficit.
I would like to see one of the fighters come away with a big combination, get away from the clinch. Not much is going on there. They got to push. They got to try to excel. They've got to try to go for the win here.
And this is where it gets tough, isn't it? The cardio starts to hurt. The final 3 minutes. Good work from Shannon Wiratchai. Not for the first time, gives his opponent a little nod. The elbow again. That's the second time he's done that, having ducked under a punch. The counter elbow. Short little choppy right hand from Shannon Wiratchai.
They're both trying to pick up the pace here. They understand how important this fight is.
Did we see the first sign of fatigue there from Amir Khan? It was a bit of a sloppy punch that he threw, and he got punished for it.
And he's moving backwards now. You're seeing the game start to shift. It's starting to change. If Shannon can make a big final push here in the final 2 minutes. Ooh, big head kick just missed.
To me, Shannon looks as if he's just got a little bit more left in the tank, but has he got enough time to utilize it?
I like how Shannon's using the elbows up against the cage there against Khan. There's the takedown that I was talking about, but Shannon stuffs it. His takedown defense is so good, especially up against the cage.
We knew that cage was there. All he had to do was try and bring them both a couple of paces back. 1.5 minutes left in the final round. This one will be a close one. It's been a thriller to watch.
And guys, action.
It's been exhausting to take part in, I'm sure. The cut doesn't seem to have been a factor.
See, he's landing those sneaky elbows up against the cage. That's a new element to Wiratchai's game. I really like it. Ooh, oh, see, there it is again.
Great elbow. He's done so well with that in this fight. Wiratchai.
Rich, what do you think is going to happen here in the last minute? How do you think this guy's going to get scored? It's definitely going to leave a lasting impression in the judge's eyes. I think that could have been the nail in the coffin.
It could just give him the edge, couldn't it?
He's landing vicious ground and pound. The crowd is exploding.
They're really getting behind him as these right hand punches come down. These are the final seconds where if it's close, it could make the difference. The takedown, the industry that he showed, the solid first 10 minutes that he had. Shannon came back well in this final round, but this could be the difference maker. Final 5 seconds now. Amir Khan, if he can keep busy, could just nick it. The fight ends with Wiratchai on his back. Amir Khan throwing down the punches. And you can see how much the crowd appreciated that one. With Shannon Wiratchai, a long-time colleague of Amir Khan. I'm going to ask you who you thought won.
I don't know. I mean, Shannon really turned it on in that, you know, at that 8-minute mark and kind of pushed through.
For your winner, via split decision, Shannon Wiratchai!
The French under 63.5 kilo champion, WPMF European champion, has beaten some great Thai names, including Nopakit, Pharmongkol, Sindan, Katmu 9, and Kontak Sipunmi. 6-11 record against Thai opponents is Aziz Alali.
Go!
Sending an early message to Sangmanee. Sangmanee's southpaw stance. Look out for that left leg power. Sangmanee bounds up to his feet. Will not score as a knockdown, of course. It was a sweep. Effective, though, it means that Sangmanee has to pick himself up off the canvas, so it mentally deflates him a little.
He also scores clean techniques, so just like a combination lands, you land a nice right hand or a big kick, it's going to score kind of the same way in the judge's eyes. Here goes Halali's nice and light on his feet, trying to move around. Our stat sheet has them dead even at 180 cm, but I think Halali has a little bit of a height and reach advantage.
Overwhelming support for Sangmanee on the one fantasy game. Those playing it on the one super round, 89%, a massive 89%, the highest percentage of any contest on tonight's card. Favours Sangmanee for the win over Aziz Alali. Sangmanee left roundhouse kick, trying to force Alali back into that corner. Cracking round kick again, and a good catch and sweep there from Alali. This one at a catch weight tonight. Sangmanee's won titles across so many weight divisions. Rajadamun champion at 108, 112 and 115 pounds. Lumpini champion at 105 and 124 pounds. S1 world champion at 110 pounds. Oh, look at that nice little step across and trying to fire the left hand. Comes in there from Lali, trying to manhandle and bully Sangmanee at the moment. Spinning hook in there from Aziz Alali.
He's doing a good job of just mixing up his attacks. He's not giving Sangmanee the same weapon over and over again so he can start developing his timing. What we've seen from Sangmanee in the past is a gigantic left kick and immediately following in with the left hand. Let's see if Alali can mix things up enough to keep Sangmanee on his back foot. He's pushing forward a lot right now.
This is Muay Thai in 4-ounce gloves. Knees, elbows, all the good stuff. Alali, southpaw stance now for the French Moroccan. Switches back to orthodox. Inside leg kick from Alali. And we go to the towels at the end of one. Look at the beautiful sweep there. Took out the support leg, did Aziz Alali. It's beautiful technique, catch and sweep.
Yeah, that was three beautiful dumps from Alali. He's really mixing up the weapons nicely. Look at that.
Aziz Alali, maybe you give the first round the French Moroccan, who opened up with a wicked right round.
That's really important in these early rounds. Typically, I've seen Sangmanee start slower in that first round. So if that round went to Aziz Alali, it's a good little way to get on the board and get there early, because now the pressure is going to be on Sangmanee. Now Sangmanee is starting to push forward, getting a little bit more aggressive.
As I said earlier, Sangmanee's never lost to a French opponent, 3-0, including a win over Rafi Bohic, who he beat in Thailand last October. 6-0 overall against European opponents. Looping a right hand there from Aziz Alali. Last time Sangmanee finished an opponent was in December. He TKO'd Martin Avery of Ireland in the second round in Pattaya. Good inside leg kick from Alali.
See, Sangmanee thought he was going up top and he started to twitch back. He's looking for that lean back defense, but Alali was starting to go to the leg, touching up twice on that leg kick.
Sangmanee's had some big wins in his time. I say in his time, he's 22 years old, but he's been around for so long. Beat the likes of Pompeii, Chikwanda, Super New Nine, Wuntai, PK, Sunshine, Wuntai, Jim. This goes on good, cutting inside leg kick. Sangmanee trying to take out the support leg again.
You see the balance. I think Sangmanee understands what that's coming. He knows how to deflect it properly. With the balance shown by Sangmanee. But I like the mix up of weapons. Great job of changing things up in the system.
We spoke about Sangmanee winning that 2012 Sports Writer of the Year award in Thailand. In 2015, Aziz Alali won the Muay Thai TV Awards Fighter of the Year award. Time there from Sangmanee. Alali inside leg kick. All the accolades that Aziz Alali has, beating Sangmanee tonight would be the highlight of the French Moroccan's career. Tries to curl the right hand over the top, goes back to center ring. On the balls of his feet. And the stance of Alali, you could almost envision him in a taekwondo uniform. Right in the heart of the ball, the finish drops the hands a little lower. He's very straight up. He's not crouched down, looking through the brow too much. Sometimes he slips into that taekwondo stance. Taekwondo guard. House kick down. Final seconds of the second round of three. Alali's certainly oozing with confidence. It's been a good performance from him. One more round to go.
You've got the forward pressure coming from Sangmanee, but the artistic display coming from Halali. Just a lot of back and forth action. There it is. See, he's starting to time that high kick. Sangmanee sees it coming. He has a beautiful lean back.
Nearly died in 2014, Sangmanee. He was poisoned before his match with Fanochar. Southpaw starts with the gold. Halali will switch between Southpaw and Orthodox. A cagey character is the towering French Morocco.
Beautiful push kicks and defensive strategy coming from Halali. The way he's able to keep Sangmanee away. Sangmanee's always pushing forward. And he sees that head kick coming. So I like the strategy of going low to that leg kick from Halali. Sangmanee usually just hustles people around, especially inside that clinch, throwing people around, ragdolling, if you will. Halali's not giving him an inch.
Nice dump. You see Halali tried to hook the leg and dump Sangmanee. Sangmanee said, no, you're going down. Solid left hand there from Sangmanee. Halali moves into the clinch range. Some knees here from Sangmanee, trying to fold him in half like origami. Halali turns him against the ropes, chance for the elbows. It's a knee again from Sangmanee. These will score well for the tie.
Look how he's putting those hips into that. He just drives that knee right into the midsection of Halali. Scoring a lot of points with these knees right now.
Sangmanee, who comes in having won his last five between May and October this year, all by decision. Is he 90 seconds away from another decision win on one Super Series debut? And there again, the Taekwondo stylings of Aziz Halali. You see it quite clearly. Very much WTF Taekwondo, the type of Taekwondo you see in the Olympic Games. Quick shuffles, low hands. This is not a clear-cut decision by any stretch of the imagination, folks. I'm telling you now. You could not tell me clearly at the moment who has won this one, who is winning this one. It could go either way. Three judges are ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system as Halali lands up. Elbow and then throws a spinning hook in. More of that Taekwondo style is coming in from Aziz Halali.
But it eats up a little bit of time too, getting back up off the canvas like that. Ate up about 7 seconds. Halali needs each of these seconds to score points. Look at this aggression coming from Sangmanee. He's starting to score a lot of points with this forward pressure.
Referee Onari needs to remove the project armband off the left arm of Sangmanee. It's come loose. It's around his wrist. Doesn't see it though on his blind side. Sangmanee, left roundhouse kick. Final 10 seconds of the round. Of the contest. It looks like we're going down to the judges. Aziz Halali puts the fist up. He believes he's won it. Final flush of roundhouse kicks. Halali draws a short straw. We are going down to the judges. Out of four, Aziz Halali.
I don't know, man. You can't let your opponent off the hook, even when you believe in your heart of hearts that you won that match. You have to utilize every single precious second.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Sangmanee Satyan.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.